non-believer is a sinner. A non-believer does not know our ways. A non-believer
has relit our most sacred flame. We need Joseph. He cleanses our sins.
Father will absolve the sinner.
Send the sinner to the north.
Family of New Eden, you have searched your hearts and truly believe that this sinner should seek our father?
Yes.
It is certain.
The father shows mercy to sinners. After all, we are all his children.
Prepare the sacrament.
Yes. Prepare the sacrament.
Give them the drink.
The father guides us in this moment.
Make them drink, please.
The sinner is granted pilgrimage north. They will bring back the father.
Praise be to Joseph.
Amen.
This will allow you to cross the threshold and live. Bring back proof of his death. They will at last understand I am their prophet, and they'll give you the help you need. We both get what we want. We will show you the way. Listen well. Joseph has a sanctuary far to the north. Ritual demands you light signal fires along the way. I doubt the old man is alive to even see them, but if you don't light the fires, it will be the death of you. Because despite the sacrament, the north can still kill you. This boat and the fire are your best means of safe, swift passage. Stray from them only when it's absolutely necessary. Use your bow to light the signals with fire arrows. Bring me proof of my father's death, and I will make sure you are remembered as a friend of the Prophet. Go now, with my blessing.
Thank you. I did everything that I was asked. I sacrificed myself, my family. I led us into the new world. I thought that it would be glorious. Was wrong. I have waited so long for someone to come. I've begun to despair. I've seen your face before. God showed it to me in a dream. I knew you would be the one to come and make things right. Set them exactly the way they're supposed to be. I knew that you would bring salvation. You've come seeking help. I can't give you any, only God can. He has a plan for you. Come. Walk with me.
You have come here to help your people. Adnan.
After God's cleansing fire, I saw the journey he had laid out before me.
humanity emerged. I gathered my flock and set them on a new path. A rejection of everything connected to the old world. The creation of a new society. Living off the land. Taking only what was needed. When the harshest news of the dark winter fell, I despaired. And in that despair, I found now salvation. This tree, it's fruit of gift from God, which gave my family the strength to endure through the famine and the pestilence. New Eden thrived. We created a paradise on Earth. But it did not last. This plague of locusts saw to that. These highwaymen embody everything God has instructed us to forsake. Their souls are rotten, diseased. But you are different. I believe your soul is worthy. Is the help that you've been seeking. God's gift to us. That which sustained my family through the darkest time. First time that I partook of this gift, I was confronted by a ravenous beast. It was my soul. And in that moment, I knew that in order to be worthy of God's gift, I had to slay that beast. I had to cleanse my soul. Because if I did not, I knew that that beast would consume me. This is God's test. And your soul. I can return from my exile. Our miracle allowed us to survive, but its gifts are not unconditional. It nourishes what is in a person's soul. But if that soul is corrupt, The miracle extracts a terrible price. Listen to my guidance, or you will not survive. When the beast rises, strike true. That is why I am here. There are those who must not be allowed to partake of this miracle. even if I love them, even if they are of my family, sin is a beast we cannot be. Come with me to New Eden.
Our future depends on adherence to my strictures. We can no longer hope for Joseph to save us. He is not coming back. We must put him out of our minds and... Father.
Ethan. Father?
Father.
Where have you been? Our land is under siege, our people threatened. You disappeared. You left us when we needed you most. Why?
To hear God's plan, my son. To hear God's plan. My children, I know that you have suffered, and I know that you are afraid. I've been gone from you for a very long time, but you were not abandoned. God spoke to me, and he has shown me a path out of this darkness. We will no longer hide behind these walls. We will no longer simply hope that this plague of locusts leaves us in peace. The time to fight is now. And God has sent us his sword. Here! God has tested their soul, and it is just, and it is pure. And I stand here before you to bear witness that this outsider is our shepherd.
Father!
And together, we will battle against the hordes outside our gates, and together we will march towards the future that God has promised us.
No! You abandoned me. You abandoned us. Without a word, without instructions, leaving me to lead as best I could. And now, you return. As if descended from the clouds and presumed to lead?
Yes.
I am the leader here.
Joseph is our leader.
New Eden follows me!
We stand behind the Father.
Son, I know you've carried a heavy burden in my absence. I understand that. This is God's will. And sometimes we must sacrifice that which we want in order to honor God's command.
What have you ever sacrificed?
Someday you will see the light. I promise.
Come. Let us all go together. We have much work to do.
I wish to speak with you. Already my chosen fight the highwaymen throughout the long nights. Now I will ask them to find the strength to fight in the day as well. Your friend should make good use of the distraction and act quickly. My family cannot fight forever. As for you, remember God's gift. What you have experienced so far is just a taste of God's power. Do not waste it. I will also give leave for my judge to follow you. They speak only one language, that of violence. In this, they will serve you well. Before you can be our shepherd, you must be our sword. Go, and make the land safe for all who wish to live in peace.
Every time.